Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the day of the video. Darren, how's it going today? Today we are at
eating an apple, pulling a bag on,
and we are currently heading off out. It's a Friday today, and I'm off today because I've got a flex today, and the weekend is obviously tomorrow. But the weather is going to be all miserable tomorrow, apparently, and on Sunday. According to the forecast, it's going to be rainy, potentially snowy. So I'm getting everything I need to do out the house done today, so that if I'm cooped up for the next 2 days, it doesn't really matter. So yeah, otherwise, I've had quite a quiet morning, to be honest with you. I got up at 8, but I just kind of like watched YouTube videos in bed until about 9. Got up, got dressed, had a shower, breakfast, all that kind of stuff. And then I was sorting out something with Virgin Media, because they sent a letter through my door saying that like I could get a better package. Like they've analysed my account and I could get a better deal. I ring them up and they just try and sell me, it says please ring this number, ring them up and they just try and sell me fucking they try and sell me a TV package and a phone package. How fucking cheeky is that? They made me pay to ring them for them to try and sell me something. Jesus. So yeah, that was pretty cheeky of them. But then otherwise I sorted out videos. It took me twice as long as normal because I uploaded a video and the clips were all in the wrong order. So I'm an idiot, basically. And sometimes when you like click and drag all of the video clips, but you click and drag it from like one in the middle, it assumes that's the first one and then goes in that order. So it like starts halfway through. So once it had uploaded, I've written the description, I had to take it down, do it all again. So well, I covered and pasted the description though, but yeah, so that was annoying. And now I'm heading off out. You will notice from my floppy hair that I'm probably going to go get my hair cut. It's the only other time I don't gel it. So that's my aim of attack. I've also got a bag, which is weird. The only time I ever take a bag is when I am either got my camera and that's it basically, but today I am taking something back to the shop because I ordered some jeans online and they've got a zip. I don't like zip jeans, so I'm taking them back. So that's why I've got my bag with me as well. But yeah, and otherwise on this bit of road here, look, see how it's basically, it's really thin road, and here's a bus coming. If that bus comes up the hill, no car can get past that. So everyone has to just stop, right? This will be the road that I end up having to pick Lewis up from. And we need to face that way. It's going to be a bastard. but anyway, it's by the by. What else have we been doing today? Gosh, while it is nice and sunny out, it's not quite as bloody warm as it feels, as it looks. God damn, it's cold. But yeah, otherwise I've been budgeting. Oh yeah, I love me some budgeting. And I've been doing some maths and some thinking and all of that kind of good stuff. And I've been basically calculating like how much money I need to put into this account, how much I'm spending every month, how much I'm getting from my wages every month, and all that kind of good news. And I've been going through it all, figuring it out exactly how much I'll have like after a certain amount of time. Like basically, when I leave work, how much will I have? How much can I reliably and easily see this? Look, it's basically single. This isn't two, like it's basically one way in it. You know what I mean? Why is with the traffic? Oh god, I think it's that motorway. The M32 is closed northbound. Jesus Christ! It's like Friday midday. Why aren't you all at work? But anyway, so we've got all that kind of stuff. Right, we've I figured out how much I can reliably put away, how much that means I live off a week, how much that means I can average on all that kind of stuff. Obviously there's going to be things that I don't, like I'm living off I think £61 a week, which I normally average about £30 to £40, but then obviously there's electricity bills which aren't counted inside that count thing. Some guy just talked to him, like, I don't even know what you said, mate. Your Bristolian accent was so thick, I had no idea. Just going walking. But yeah, so I've been thinking about, like, all that kind of stuff. Figuring out how much I can put away and all that. But I've counted every single bill except the electricity bill. But I also haven't counted my student loan. so that easily pays for it and then some. But yeah, so I can put away that X amount. I've also applied for student finance, which means I can put away another X amount and I can actually pay myself quite a wage next year. Like, because I don't want to go back and work in a supermarket while I'm in my final year, and Laura's going to be living with me as well, I'm going to be living in Bristol, commuting back and forth, we need to be quite financially stable, I guess. So after doing all of the maths, and as of the second I leave my current job now, I'll have 2/3 of my current annual salary to last the year, plus hopefully Laura's stuff. This is including loans, and all of my savings. Oh, ambulance. So yeah, we should be good. We've got good. It's really, like, I've never actually gone through and budgeted how much I spend, how much is on bills, how much I spend on a normal basis. Bloody hell. Yeah, it's kind of good because I've never really sat down and figured out exactly how much I spend, how much I can save, and all of that. I've kind of just done it roughly and just gone off the averages of the past couple of months or whatever. But I've actually sat down and done it, and it's actually really good. And I'm going to keep that figure in mind as I live out my next couple of months, as I pocket every single penny I possibly can do. And all of my budgeting doesn't include things like this, Google dollars, the YouTube moolah. It doesn't count that. That is a separate entity. It's not a lot, but it's a bit. I think I'll use that either to like treat myself so that I don't hit my actual, you know what I mean? I don't know what I'm doing with it. It's completely unaccounted for money. But things like that, and things like tax rebates, which I'll get next year because I'm paying tax this year, but I don't need to. Like, I don't count that because they're not reliable. Google specifically isn't reliable. Like, you've only just paid yourself off now. This camera and my other daily vlog camera are now free because Google paid for them. But it didn't pay for my main channel camera or the main channel camera before that or anything else. So 5 years in and I've earned enough to buy 2 cameras. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, and I've used 4. GG. All right, there we go. A lot shorter. There's a bloody lot of gel in it as well. That guy can bloody talk about football. Jesus Christ. I don't want to know about how you're setting up a football team. Just cut my hair. I'm not paying you for a conversation. Telling me how he's setting up a football team and it's all about the pace and da 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 da. And Jesus Christ, dude. Makes me so angry. Also, car park there, £2.50 for 2 hours. Isn't too bad at all, is it? Otherwise as well, I need to figure out how to get rid of hairs off of a white Converse, because god damn it. Look how gorgeous that looks. Just went past a subway that's like attached to, this is basically a massive university building block. I think that might be as well, actually. It's just filled with students. He says, haven't eaten a hot dog. The same price as they are spending, and they probably got a drink as well, and I'm pretty thirsty, so who's the mug? Oh, but otherwise, got everything we needed, refunded my jeans, and sorted out everything else in my little life. Yeah, did that, and I've also been wandering around, got myself some lunch, wandered around a bit, and even though I've now decided that I'm budgeting myself heavily for the next however many months, I have decided what my next lens will be for my camera. I've been hunting for, since I got it basically, I got 2 lenses that I knew would be good for absolutely everything. But, well, no, they are very, very good. They're great. And I need to use them more, to be fair, before I go around buying a new one. I'm not going to buy a new lens in a long ass time. But I've decided which one I want, because I was looking at like the 50mm, but the 50mm lens on my camera doesn't really make sense. Like, it's not a logical thing to do, because they say that like 50mm, well, you either get a 35mm or a 50mm if you're going to get like a non-zoom lens. This probably means nothing to people who don't know cameras. Then the two to have are 35 or 50. 35 is the most versatile, 50 is usually the better looking, but that's for full frame. So once you have a crop sensor on it, then you need to start considering like multiplication factors. So 50 is actually closer to 70 on a crop sensor. And the reason I want like the 50 is because, like, well, I don't, it's not perfect because it doesn't have image stabilization. That's like something that's really important to me. But it doesn't have it, which is a downside. But because it's so wide open, you can shoot in low light, which means I can film a video when I get in from work, and it does a lot better than mine does at the moment, because that's like 3.5 minimum aperture compared to 1.8. But 50mm is all 70mm, is very zoomed in. And it's like next to impossible to focus the lens and record yourself. It's like a two-man job where you need a remote of some kind. And you have to stand really far away because it's obviously so zoomed in. But one of the biggest problems with it is you can't rely on the autofocus. You know how on my camera, for those of you who've been watching for a while, on my camera, my smaller lens focuses great in autofocus, but as soon as you put it to video mode, it really struggles to focus when it's the big lens, because it's a focus by wire focus system, I believe. I think that's what it is in my big lens, but, or if it isn't, then it's the one slightly better than that. I don't know what that is. Actually, I think it might be a silent step motor, and it's not that silent. But focus by wire is even worse than that, and it just means you can't rely on the autofocus on the 50mm lens. So, I've no one that's going to be better. It's quite a bit more expensive, but it's 30mm, so once you apply crop factor, it's closer to 50 than the 50 is. And it's got a wider aperture as well, so I think it's 1.4. And it's got proper focus, like the other camera. It's got the same focusing system as my good focusing lens, which is good news, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, so yeah, anyway, I've got off the busy streets now. traffic. I've got to drive to Bath, man, in this traffic. But yeah, while everyone's beeping the bloody horn, it really annoys me. Yeah, so while it's not great for video, this road is still gridlocked, look. What the fuck? But anyway, yeah. While the two things I look for in a camera, for my main channel, the two times that I'm going out, I either film videos on a tripod, in which case image stabilization isn't important. The two important things are wide focus, view. What's that called? Wide view, and also traffic is mayhem. So the two best things to have for tripods when I'm filming a vlog, the wide aperture, because then I can do it in low light, and you can have a nice blue background, and a wide view focus, so I don't have to stand super far away. So in both ways it's better there. And in scenarios where I go out and film, like I do with you, if I was to do that with the main channel, the things that are important to me are image stabilization and a zoom, because of just the style of videos I make. So in that case, I won't even think I'll be using it. It'll be more a photography out, video in kind of thing. I don't know. But I'm saying all this, it's like £200, which is a lot of money. So I have no intention of buying it anytime soon. But that's my lens. That's my lens. It's actually good that I found it, because I've kind of been looking at the 50mm. But it's not all it's cracked up to be, I don't think. But the problem with the 50mm is it's like £70, which is close enough to justify. It's close enough for me to go, I could buy that lens for relatively cheap. But it's not worth it, because it's not good for what I need it for. So, therefore, fall in love with a more expensive lens that I can never buy and never waste my money. Budgeting tips from Jamie. Even this road's on a standstill. Jesus. What's going on? How am I going to get to Bath? Traffic like this, man. If you want something, fall in love with the most expensive version you can, and that way all the cheap ones you can actually afford will never be a good enough substitute. And B, once you've saved up for it and you can actually afford it, you feel great. And C, chances are you never afford it. Or you can never justify spending so much money on what is essentially a piece of glass. So there's my tips for you, if you want to save money. Otherwise, I'm heading home. I'm going to check travel news and figure out if there's an easy way of getting to Bath without coming down either this hill or that hill there, which I'm going to assume is even worse. I bet this is all down to the motorway being closed. So they're all funneling out and going different ways. I'll have a look. But I do need to get to Bath today, so I could go tomorrow. But is it going to be better tomorrow? Look at all the red on that traffic map. Bloody hell, eh? Ooh, so the fastest way to Bath, because of all of this mess with the traffic is the M4, which is a bastard because it's like 10 miles further. Damn it. Well, either way, I'm going to have to go now, aren't I? Because it's nearly, well, it's 2:30. So by the time I've been there, if I want to spend like an hour on campus having a look around, which I'll do a little bit, I want to go and check out the new computer science buildings, then I'm going to have to leave now. Otherwise, I'm going to be hitting rush hour traffic on the way back. I want to nip back. I want to be on the way back at 4. So I can dodge traffic, in theory. Touch wood. I'm going to need a shower. I'm just covered in hairs. Google Maps says there's about a 2-minute difference between the two options. So I will go whichever way it takes me. And if it takes me one way, I might try the other way on the way back. Just for the experience, I guess. I'm going to take a coat because it's cold out, but I don't want to wear it because it's going to be too hot in the car. So, have I got a hoodie as well underneath there? No. Bloody heavy, man. Jesus. Right, let's rock and roll. Diverted traffic. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Councillor Bristol doesn't know how to keep its roads open. So it's closed the road at the bottom of my road, which explains heavily why all the other ones are all, like, so heavily trafficated and stuff. It's closed that road, which means everyone who's trying to get to the motorway, which is actually open, can't get there because that road's closed. Oh dear. God damn it. I've got my sat nav on. My sat nav's taking me down here to the right, which is where the official shit is. I'm thinking of going left, swooping up by Sainsbury's and going that way. But we are making a habit of moving, so I literally may as well turn the engine off. Jesus wept. Beth, you fucking owe me big time. The weekend you want it picked up is the weekend of the Bath Half Marathon. Fuck you, Beth. It's literally rammed. Just traffic is everywhere. Oh dear. You've got diversions left. Bristol's equally as bad, which is why it's literally taken me an hour to get to here. I'm not even there yet. It's supposed to take 20 minutes to drive there. Ugh. 40 minutes? I don't know how long it's supposed to take. But I'm not even in the city yet. I'm literally just pulling off the motorway to get into it. Oh. Fucking hell. Fucking hell's bells. Me and traffic. What I want to do, right, from now on, whenever I go driving somewhere, I'm going to leave at 7:30 in the morning. Before anyone even, 7:20 in the morning, before anyone else is even considering getting on the road, that's when I'm leaving. And I'm leaving to go home at 4. It's nearly 4 now. Ooh, dear, oh dear, oh dear. You owe me big time, Beth. I don't know how you're going to have to repay me, but my God, it's going to be expensive. Jesus Christ, well, we're on campus now. It's 4:30. Fucking hell. What is with the roads? Jesus wept. Right, okay. Let's pack everything away. You come here, Mr. Satnav. Thank you. Let's put you into there to sleep. Let's go get some parking, because I'm going to get an hour's worth of parking. So may as well have a look around and then head back. Jesus Christ alive, man. I swear to God. It's not that much fun. I'm going to leave at 4:15 so that I can go back properly and, like, you know what I mean. The best time to leave campus is about 10 to, because lectures kick out at 4:15. 5:15. So you get in just as, like, the last, like, it's always mental traffic and buses and stuff trying to leave at that time. But I'm not going to stay along because I need to get back. It's 4:30. If it takes me another hour and a half to get back, I'm not going to get back till 6. Ah, oh, Beth, God damn it! Oh, that's a new accommodation. This was a computer science building. What do you reckon it is now? It still says Department of Computer Science on it. Brilliant. School of Management taking over my building. What the hell? Otherwise, that's finished. That looks very shiny and pretty looking. That's the arts hall. I'll see if it's open, actually. It should be open. I'm going to try and weasel my way in. I'm surprised they're allowed to do it in silver, though. Like, everything else is yellow and black. Do a silver building. Reflective in the summer. Let's see if I can break in and have a look. Break in. God. Cool, no rest for the wicked. Building something new there. God damn it. Where aren't they building stuff? This place isn't going to have a campus soon. It's just going to be... It's going to have its own city. It'll just be a city university in the middle of nowhere. I don't reckon I can get down there. I'm going this way. God. I was hoping I'd find out what that is, but this place used to have quite a big campus until they started building shit everywhere. It's got pretty popular though, hasn't it, since over the past couple of years, since I came here. Great, the building next to ours is another one that's being refurbed. Brilliant. It actually feels really weird coming back to campus. I don't feel like I belong here anymore. It feels weird knowing that I will be coming back at some point next year. That feels strange. Right, computer science building. Last time I was here, this wasn't even open or finished yet. So, ooh, that's like a proper video thing. So is that, oh, that's exciting. I'm allowed in here as well. Because it's me. I do think Eb was better though. It's lacking the computer labs, that's the problem. Seems quite small, but it's good because it's like in the centre of campus now instead of all the way off in the middle of its own, on its own, like, but it hasn't got as many computers. That's what we need, computers. Right, let's go pick up me fucking Beth's package. Let's get out of here. Just walked past someone who said it's a 15-minute drive to Bristol. Bullshit, my friend, I've just come from there. It's not there anymore. It's Eastwood somewhere. I don't even know where Eastwood is. I think I know where Eastwood is, but I don't know where the mail room is there. Where are we going to? Eastwood Lodge. Whatever that is. I think it's behind Salisbury in Marlborough. But otherwise, Eastwood Lodge left. Is that you? Institute of Contemporary... Nope, student parcel delivery. I guess that kind of makes sense, actually. It's all the way over there, because... Well, they've set up their own... We used to always have to go to Westwood to go get packages and stuff, which is where I went to. But obviously we've just opened massive new accommodation on Eastwood, so they're probably going to need their own shit now, aren't they? Eastwood's obviously the east side of the campus. Eastwood, I think, is that thing. This is Marlborough, that's Salisbury. Then you've got whatever the new stuff's called, and Woodland. But on the other side you've got Westwood, and Westwood's like friggin' huge. These are called quads, apparently, and it's Ebony, Damson and Chestnut are the three I've seen. What are they? Are they colours? Chestnut? I don't know. It's weird though, isn't it? Oh, quick wee break and then we'll roll. I was going to stay on campus and get a drink, but I ain't got time. Got shit to do, man. Fucking hell. Which way am I going back? I don't think I'm going the motorway. But then again, like, the south of Bristol's basically closed. So I'm best off going north in the motorway. But there wasn't much traffic, like, that way. You know what I mean? It was all going in, not out. So I might be best off going that which way, actually. Because I know if I go the other way, it's going to route me through through to where all the roads closed are in Bristol, and then in basically the town centre, which is just rammed. So I think I'm going to have to override it and just go on my own back. Oh. Yeah, it is quite strange coming back here. It's strange knowing that in, like... Because, like... Part of me feels like I've left here forever now. Now I've got a job and all that kind of stuff. Now I've got my placement. But I also know that in half a year or whatever, I'm going to be here virtually 9 till 5. Or, to be honest, I'll leave at 6 o'clock and get here at 7, do my lectures and hope they're all in the morning. Then I'll leave at 2 and avoid traffic, hopefully. But it's weird. It's a weird feeling, it is. Because part of me feels like I've left. But the other half of me knows that I'm probably going to spend more time here. Well, obviously, except first year, where I spent all my time here. Spend more time here than I have in year two. I'm going to have to sort out routes and stuff and figure out how long it takes to get here and do a couple of test runs at live student time and all that noise to figure out when's best to go. Oh, God, it's going to be hard work next year. I'm not looking forward to it at all. Ah, there she is. Good girl. Good girl. I did it, ladies and gentlemen. Whew. At last, I've done it. I am now a world record holder. If you look up in the Guinness World Records, I am the first man in the history of the world to see all of the UK's diversion signs in just one day. I'd like to thank my family. I'd like to thank Laura. Without them, I wouldn't be where I am today. And most of all, I'd like to thank Beth. Thanks, Beth. Oh, well, I guess I should get on to some cooking then, eh? Since it's 6:40. Jeez Louises. The sausage and mash tonight as well, because I thought, well, I've got loads of free time today. So I'll have, like, tomorrow, I'm going to be busy filming and editing and stuff. So I will make sure that I've got enough... what am I talking about? I'll make sure that I've got enough time to... Sorry, my brain. Do all of that stuff instead of... do all of that stuff instead of cooking. Fuck. Look at me. I'm just trying to find a YouTube video and I can't. And it's stressing me out and I can't talk to you at the same time. I'm the worst, aren't I? Okay. Sausage and mash. This takes a while, doesn't it? Sausage and mash. So, let's get the speaker out and everything. I'm going to go through all of these. I'm going to watch every single video. And if I don't like it, I'm going to unsubscribe. That's what I'm going to do now. Because I've got too many that I just scroll past. I only watch like 5 different people, so... Right, so we have finished our dinner now. It's the evening time, and I have to plan videos that I'm going to be filming tomorrow. I could do some video editing now, but Netflix has just launched House of Cards, so we might start that instead. I'm going to start that, and I'm going to start, like, setting up a plan for the videos that I'm going to do tomorrow on paper for a change, because I haven't done that in a while. I do need to write blogs for these, and I've got a blog to write as well, so I might go to bed and watch, like, The Killing or something, as I, or maybe Sherlock, maybe. I don't know, but it is nearly 9 o'clock, so it is actually quite late. Oh, it's also quite cold as well, I might put the heating on. No. But it is fucking freezing. So, we'll see if we can hold on for an hour. Put it on at 10 till 11. That sounds good to me, and then I'll be in bed. On my laptop anyway, so I don't need... To be fair though, I did wake up in the middle of the night a couple of times, literally freezing. I was like, ah, it's so cold. Trying to cuddle up into my hot water bottle, which had gone cold by that time. Ah, right. House of Cards Series 3. Let's start this bad boy. And let's get out my good old-fashioned YouTube book. And I'm heading to bed, ladies and gentlemen. I've been writing a load of stuff in my book. But I've decided I'm not filming tomorrow. I'll be editing and writing ideas and stuff. I need a proper good plan. And I haven't got that yet. I got to the point where I'm jotting down things like that would be like must mentions or stuff like that. I got to the point where I'm like, I'm brainstorming all the things that I like, all of my experiences, trying to pull what I want to talk about, and then I've just got like 2 full pages of the experiences. I'm like, fuck me, dude, this is a lot bigger than I imagined it was. So it needs a lot more filtering, a lot more fettling before I can actually stand up and start talking about it on the main channel. Oh dear! No! But yeah, so put a water bottle in the bed. And yeah, so I've been doing that a bit. Stopped about a while ago though. I've watched the first episode of House of Cards, pretty good. And the very last episode of Pramface, which is really sad. Because I really liked that show. But yeah. So that's me basically now for the evening. It's been a long video, hasn't it? So I'm going to get going. Thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Tomorrow we are going to be working here. Potentially going out and doing some stuff out and about, potentially with my camera. I haven't been out with my camera for a while, so I kind of want to do that. But also blogging and writing video ideas and video editing. All of that fun stuff. Filming Sunday. I'll catch you later.